Hey guys, it's Chris from TapTech, and this is the video tutor review of the Samsung ATIV Smart PC, Windows 8 based tablet with S Pen integrated. You also get a keyboard if you like. In Europe, the price is 799 euros for the keyboard dock and the ATIV Smart PC. In the US, should be the same in dollars. There's also a 3G version which costs 100 euro more, so you pay 899 euros for the 3G tablet and the keyboard dock. At quite high price for a low power tablet, because you get just an Intel Atom CPU and a very cheap plastic case, but more to that later. First of all, let's go around the device. We got here an 11.6 inch screen with a resolution of 1366 by 768. It also has integrated digitizer which supports up to 1024 levels of pressure density, and that's pretty great here. It's also working very well, so maybe you know it from the Galaxy Note 10.1, which has the same Wacom digitizer integrated. Otherwise, we have a 2 megapixel camera in the front, two speakers here on the left and on the right side, which are working pretty good here, pretty good sound quality, and also the position is quite nice because you're in the middle of the sound field if you're working with the tablet. Then we got here a dedicated Windows button, and let's go to the top where the important connectors. Here we got the audio connector, the on-off button, a lock for the screen rotation. Then we got here a full USB port in its 9.9 millimeter thin case here, so pretty nice for that, pretty cool. We got here two microphones. Then we got here a micro SD slot, which is also very important because if you buy the 64 gigabyte version from the ATIV Smart PC, you only will have around 31 gigabytes left after first start and the updates. If you buy the 3G version, here is the slot where you put in your SIM card. On the right side, there is just the S Pen, as you can see here. It's kind of hard to get it out, but it holds in, so that's also good here. And on the bottom, we get a connector for the keyboard dock, also here two slices. And there is a connector for charging the tablet, which isn't the best position, because if you just hold your tablet and want to put it on your table and you have connected to your charger, it is not the best position just here. Then we got here a micro HDMI port on the left side, so you easily can connect it to your TV, and also a volume rocker, so pretty nice for that. A lot of connectors on your tablet by itself. On the back, we got just the 8 megapixel camera with its LED flash and the Samsung logo. Nothing else here. In terms of weight, it weighs around 744 grams, so pretty heavy, but if you think that's a 11.6 inch tablet, it's quite okay. What we don't like is that it's just plastic. As you can see, it's the same design, it's the same material from the Galaxy S3 and also Galaxy Note 2, but the problem is this is an 11.6 inch tablet, so it's huge compared to a smartphone, and if you see this on a tablet, it just feels very, very cheap. Please, Samsung, change that in the future, because that's not great, and if you think that one has a price tag of around 800 euros or dollars, so you know what I mean. That's really not great. Also, if you give light pressure here, you can see it grabs in. Also, it just does not feel great. And as you can see, there are a lot of fingerprints here because it's glossy surface. And also in terms of build quality, that one isn't great because you can see here a lot of problems here also with the lag. So not pretty nice here on the ATIV Smart PC. And then we go to the keyboard dock, which is quite nice, quite okay. The layout is pretty good here. The keys are big enough to type, pretty good to type here. What we didn't like is the trackpad here, which feels kind of fancy. doesn't work exact where you what you expect it from. And also, as you can hear when you're clicking, sounds cheap. And it's also same like the tablet. It's plastic, but it's not glossy. Pretty good for that one. There's also no battery integrated, but you get two USB ports on the left and also here one on the right side. And there's also connected to charge your tablet. This one here is kind of metal. It's pretty nice and holds your tablet, but the problem is that the connector isn't connecting very well the tablet. You might hear that when I try to connect the tablet with the keyboard dock. Start it and here we go. I just put it in here and then I try to connect, but you can see it connects and disconnects often. And also the angle of this one isn't great. It isn't the best, could be a bit more that it is better to work, but for the most cases it's quite okay and quite nice to work with the keyboard dock. And in terms of trackpad, you can use a Bluetooth mouse, your touchscreen, or just a USB mouse, because you get here two USB connectors. So quite nice here, the keyboard dock. But we would wish us battery integrated in this keyboard. Let's disconnect it, and here we go. In terms of display, the display from the ATIV Smart PC is quite okay. In terms of colors, in viewing angles, also in brightness, it's nice. And what the best thing is that you have a digitizer, which works very well here, because you got this S Note application, which you know from the Galaxy Note 10.1, and you can write here. But you can see there are sometimes problems. Let's go out and start it again. Okay, it's just now. So there are some issues with the software, but you can write and it should recognize what you're writing here in this tool. But in my opinion, it's not the best tool for students and so on, because you might know it or you might use it already. Is Microsoft OneNote. We got here, we tried it out before. Quite nice to try. And here we can write something and say hello, how are you? ? And just get to sign and put it in the text. And it will be here. And so that's pretty cool here, to write just with this tablet. And you make signs or formulas or whatever. So that's pretty great here with the ATIV Smart PC and its integrated digitizer and the S Pen. In terms of performance, we got this Intel Atom dual core CPU, which is quite great in terms of energy efficiency, because the tablet holds for around 8 hours in a normal use. So if you're surfing a bit, browsing, writing content, or just reading ebooks or PDFs, so that's pretty great lifetime. We also got around 10 hours by playing a video in a loop with full display brightness and connected to Wi-Fi. So that's pretty great. But in terms of performance, you don't have to expect too much, because you're not able to play newest games. Latest games had problems with this one. Also, benchmarks results showed that this one isn't the fastest tablet or the fastest Atom CPU or CPU we have ever seen. And also the internal memory isn't that fast, which quite makes some problems, or it's just that it's slow to save things or copy things, install things. It always takes a while longer than with other faster storages. So just some words for that. Otherwise, it's just great here to work with office documents, and also it's quite good here to surf in the web. Let's go to the browser, open TapTag. you will see here the performance is quite nice. And here we go, let's start or open this review where Flash Video is embedded. And might take a while. Here we go. Change this to full HD, and now we are able to play full HD videos. So there are no lags at this one. The only problem what we had is playing full HD videos here in the pre-installed video application. It didn't work here, but we were able to play full HD videos with the VLC player, media player, where we are playing our Big Bug Bunny video without any problems here. And quite good display quality, as you can see now. And also speakers are pretty great here. So, and that's it. That's the ATIV Smart PC. Should you buy it? I don't think so, because the price is too high. Just wait for a few months here, or a few weeks. The tablet will be cheaper, or will get cheaper, because it's pretty high price tag, and after a while it will get pretty lower price here. And also compared to this Acer Iconi Adapt W5 or W510, which has kind of the same specs. It doesn't have the integrated digitizer and has just a 10.1-inch screen, but in an IPS screen. This one costs $599 with around 18 hours battery life with the keyboard dock, and this one is $200 cheaper or 200 euros cheaper than this ATIV Smart PC. So just some words for that. That's it. If you wanna see more videos, just go to our YouTube channel, and if you like the video, just give a thumbs up. Thank you for watching.